Yeah, 535, this is just trying to...
Battalion Chief Mike Brown has been fighting fires in California for 26 years. But he's never seen a fire quite like the Blue Cut fire in Southern California's San Bernardino County, 60 miles east of Los Angeles.
It was like an angry fire. These were like 50, 100-foot flame lengths, you know, and I was just amazed to see the volume of a fire that we saw.
In an ever-lengthening wildfire season, Brown is dispatched to fires like this more often, for days at a time. This is his second wildfire in 2 weeks.
Fire is a year-round, and we've kind of come to the point that we understand that it's a year-round fire season for us.
California's wildfire season traditionally began in the summer when vegetation dried out and forests became more flammable. But 5 years of drought and hotter than average temperatures have shrunk the break between 1 year's fire season and the next. Drier conditions also contribute to the rapid spread and destructiveness of the fires.
What makes a fire like this so dangerous?
The reason why it's so dangerous is the intensity that it's burning. The vegetation was very dense. We had 70-year brush that hadn't been burned. No fire history in this area. Everything was in alignment.
Volatile conditions like those in the Blue Cut fire are becoming more common in other parts of the state, like the Cedar Fire at Sequoia National Forest last week.
Thousands of firefighters are battling wildfires across California this summer, and experts warn this year could be worse than ever. That's because drought, intense heat, and tree-eating beetles are causing a dramatic rise in the number of dead trees, turning forests like this one into a tinderbox.
Normally you have maybe 5% of your forest that has dead trees in it.
Paul Gibbs is a spokesman for the U.S. Forest Service.
We have never seen anything at this level and this type of mortality in recorded history that we have. To have 50 to 75% of your forest and dead trees, that's unprecedented.
Last week, Gibbs deployed to the Cedar Fire in Central California to study how the dried out trees fueled the blaze. He says the weather pattern El Nino, which typically means wetter conditions for Northern and Southern California, mostly missed Central California. With less rain, grasses and logs dried up earlier in the summer, creating more tinder for the fires.
So people thought maybe El Nino would make this year's wildfire season a little calmer. Has that been the case?
No, we're seeing just the opposite. You know, we did get a pulse of rain, which allowed the grass to really grow. And so we have a very healthy, tall grass crop this year. But we get temperatures up in the 90s and over 100, 105, you know, the grass dies. And then you have a combination of the dry grass, which will carry fire and start fires a lot easier.
Gibbs is looking for that combination of dry grass and dead trees, hoping to anticipate where the next big wildfire might spark.
I think we're in store for a pretty active fall. We've already got folks who've been out for quite a few days, but you have to start worrying about fatigue of firefighters and really pace ourselves, because then you realize, you know, this is, you know, more like a marathon race than a sprint.
A marathon that's become the new normal for firefighters like Mike Brown.
We've had numerous fires over the last few months. We have crews coming off of fires, you know, coming onto this fire. So crews are taxed, and we have our families that are taxed. So it's been cumbersome for not only firefighters, but their families as well.